Hello and welcome to Affinity. Here's a way to use the gradient map as a contrast control, in fact a double contrast. Let's start off very straightforward. You go to the gradient map and we're going to make the left black. This is on grayness at the moment. You can be anything you want there. You could be RGB sliders, and you're going to make the right white. So here we go, it's a overlay map there, but what we're going to do is in fact go to the blend mode here of overlay, or you can also go further down to the few below it, even as far as linear light. And that's a huge contrast, but don't worry about that. We'll leave it on that just to show it can be done. You could leave it at just overlay. This is going to be kind of harsher, but you're going to moderate it with opacity. In fact, you could show it here. If I turn the opacity down here, see, as I turn this down, there's the control I'm going to get within this, but I'm going to leave it like that for now. And for that, I'm going to call that increase contrast. Then I'm going to click on that and Control J to duplicate it and call this decrease contrast. And then for this one, for the top one, we're going to hit a Control I, which inverts the mask. If I take the bottom one off, so you can, it's just invisible now. So the idea is going to paint on this to bring back that contrast effect. The bottom one, we're also going to invert it, but first of all, I'll show you how it works. Double click on this, and I'm going to reverse the mask here. In fact, we could change the blend mode here if that's a bit too exaggerated. Let's go back up to, put that one on overlay. And because it's reversed, you're effectively flattening the contrast using the overlay mode. So we've got a decrease and an increase. So I can click on this now, Control I to invert it, so none of it is used. So the mask on both of these are black. So if you Alt click on that, you see the amount that's black. Now I'm going to get a paintbrush. And where I'm going to paint, in white on these here to bring it back. See, that's rather dark there, so I can change the opacity of the brush. And I can do it up here, or I can type the numbers. I go 1 gives me 10%, 2 gives me 20%, and so on. So there I've got 30%, and I can effectively, I'm painting contrast now. So a bit of contrast up over there. And then I can go to the decrease contrast, and I can paint decrease contrast. So I want to make the background a little less significant. I can paint on that. Let's make the foreground more contrasty. So we paint on here. See, we're just all over this until we're happy with it. And we can always paint back the other way, paint on white to, so we're painting white now, so paint black to reverse it and go the other direction. So in other words, here we've got a very simple increase contrast, decrease contrast mode, and that's all you do. You literally decide what you want to do. I want to increase the contrast here. So I'll do this, and so on. You can also add additional controls, if you like, using to do darken areas and so on. So I could, for example, copy the mask of the decreased contrast area here and put a curve using that mask to decrease and make the background darker. But that would make the whole thing somewhat longer. But you can do it. But the basic principle, again, increase contrast, black to white with an overlay mode. Decrease contrast, white to black with overlay. Just like that. Anyway, thank you very much for watching.